The Workplace Safety Minister says more health and safety inspectors won't necessarily improve New Zealand's safety record. The government's consulting on changes to health and safety laws, which it says are too confusing and expensive. Here's Q&A's Jack Tame.
Following the Pike River disaster, New Zealand's health and safety laws were completely revamped. But the number of workplace deaths and injuries has remained high. And per capita, the number of workplace inspectors has actually gone down.
Well, I think inspectors are very important because you look at it two ways. You need the businesses to be able to follow the law, comply with the law, but of course there's always a bit of carrot and a little bit of stick.
Per capita, Australia has almost twice as many workplace inspectors as New Zealand, but New Zealand has twice as many deaths, with a recent report indicating an average of 73 people are killed in work accidents each year. WorkSafe, the agency which oversees inspectors, has cut dozens of other jobs and is now searching for a new CEO. But the minister responsible isn't convinced that more inspectors would necessarily improve our safety record.
We're only going to see better outcomes if we're actually asking the right questions. Mm. Is it appropriate if we get 1,000 more investigators but they still just turn up to the exact same shops?
Brooke van Velden is now considering more urgent advice on what to do about engineered stone products, which are commonly used to make bench tops.
I don't want to be a reactionary politician where any red flag or any signal means that we stop the economy.
The products have been linked to debilitating and potentially fatal silicosis for some installers, although the industry says risks can be managed with good safety practices and products with lower silica content.
We need people to be able to turn up to work. We need them to be healthy. We need them to be safe.
We need them to be alive, don't we?
Of course. Absolutely. But we can't just stop everything every time we hear that there might be a potential red flag.
In Australia, a total ban on the products comes into place from July 1st. Jack Tame, One News.